in the wild on the planet, sorry, and put them into that frozen sea, and you wouldn't actually fill it. So that's how close tigers are to extinction. There's less than 4,500 wild tigers roaming the forest of Asia, and today alone, between 1 and 5 tigers will be killed today for that illegal tiger trade. So just think, we're all here in Australia, we're about to have a tiger show, it's going to be really fun, we're a bit hot. But just think, over the forests of Asia, to Sumatra, China, India, between 1 and 5 tigers will be slaughtered by poachers. So it's a really scary thought, guys. And just to put it in perspective for you, about 100 years ago, there were over 100,000 tigers roaming the forests of Asia. So in just one century, mankind has managed to wipe out about 96% of their population. So it's really sad. And unfortunately, the reason the tigers are still being hunted and poached today are, again, all because of us. So habitat destruction is a really big killer for tigers, not only because it affects their prey species, but also causes them to disperse out and get close to local villages and communities and livestock. So they get shot in that respect as well. Now, the Sumatran tiger, which is some of our younger tigers that were out earlier today, the Sumatran tiger is the smallest and the most threatened of the remaining subspecies. There's only about 350 Sumatran tigers in the wild. And in Sumatra, Indonesia, about 70% of the logging that's done there, guys, is actually done illegally. So that means that prime tiger habitat that's supposed to be protected is still being poached at an alarming rate. Now, we as Westerners, guys, unfortunately, we're one of the biggest consumers of illegally logged wood, and we don't even know it. Don't buy it, guys. The same goes for their bones and body parts, which are used in traditional Asian and Chinese medicines. We've got some examples up on that top under cutlery, guys, in that glass cabinet. Overseas, and you see a really cool souvenir that you want to bring back for a friend or a relative, make sure you're reading the label. And if it does contain tiger bones and body parts, guys, please don't buy it, because of course when the buying stops, that's when the killing will stop as well. Now, since having tigers in Australia, we've managed to raise just over $1 million. Actually, we hit that mark last year, and all that money has come from wonderful people such as yourselves and come to the zoo. You've heard about what's happening to tigers out in the wild, and you've wanted to help out. Now, that money goes towards very dedicated groups of people. At the moment, we have 6 end poaching units in Sumatra, where the Sumatran tigers are from. So they do a really wonderful job, guys. They leave their families for months at a time. They don't get paid very much. It works out to be around about 2,500 Australian a year, which is their annual salary. It's not very much money. They get shot at by poachers. They're very, very dedicated groups of men. And if you think of the lengths that these people go to support tigers in the wild, it just makes us think of all the things that we can do as well. What that stands for, guys, is $5 saved one tiger in the wild for one day. Well, it's really not that much money, and obviously you'll see most of the handlers wearing them. There's a lot of staff at the zoo wearing them. And as I said, we have raised $1 million for people like yourself, so thank you very much for that. Now I think they're about